possibility, and we'll make it together. The power from deep inside, the energy to do it right, is the exo making the wheel go round. The day that I have been thinking, planning, working on for weeks is finally here. It is my proud privilege and pleasure to welcome IIW President Trish, IIW EC members, I can see only Zenny right now, board directors present, past IIW presidents, board directors, and editors. Editors of various levels from around the world. Welcome to the Global Editors Meet. Welcome, namaste, good afternoon, good evening, as the case may be. I know it is night too in some places, but since you decided to remain awake and participate, I must say how much I appreciate your enthusiasm and commitment. It is 3 a.m. in Mexico and 10 p.m. plus in New Zealand, and still they are here with us. Assisting me today through all the screen shares, highlighting, muting, allowing people to enter, will be the valuable members of my home district, District 325, who are the Zoom host and form the tech support team. District Chairman Ragini and District EC members, of course, and specially past District Chairman Shweta Sinha, District Secretary Rashmi Gupta, District ISO Nibha Mishra, and past President Nisha Gadia. We will begin with the inner wheel prayer. May we have the video, please? There's no sound, Rashmi. Do you want me to do it? Rashmi, I'm doing it.
Instill in us, O Lord, the true meaning of friendship. Never let us forget that all thy children, notwithstanding the differences in our culture and creeds, endow us with a desire to serve our fellow men, remembering that we too often need help. Whenever or wherever the need for service arises, help me to be ready to serve, endeavoring to make our badge of inner wheel worthwhile, ensuring that we have not lived in vain.
IIW President Trish, a hearty welcome to the Global Editors Meet. This program has been possible because of your support. I need to share here that she has been open to all my ideas, even if they may seem walking on untread paths. Our centennial president needs no introduction, but instead of an introduction, I will share a short video of Trish's adventures, which well shows facets of her personality, her joyous exuberance in meeting members everywhere, her interest in all service activities in every place. May we have the video, please?
Thank you.
hope all of you like that. And wherever President Trish has been, she has surely spread joy and smiles. I would like to recognize the EC members. As I said, Zenny is here. I can't find her right now. And I'd like to welcome past presidents, international past president, Charlotte, Yemisi, and Phyllis Charter. My warm welcome to all the national representatives present here. Welcome to all the district editors, past national representatives, PDCs, and members. Your presence here has boosted our morale. This Zoom event has raised curiosity for sure. I have been asked what was the point in it. I'll try to explain, even though it may seem a bit fanciful and perhaps confusing. Today, the old adage, pen is mightier than the sword, has a wider context. Communication, sharing of information is of utmost importance. No one denies that. Within the club or the organization, letters, reports, minutes, bulletins, the channel of communication is well established. But what about the arena outside our clubs? What about our town, country, world? Do they know InnerWheel enough? How will they know about InnerWheel? You will answer that, of course, through media, newspapers, social media. Communication has changed monumentally. By using the popular methods of websites, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, TV, we can spread the principles, purpose, and projects of InnerWheel globally. The outside world gets the opportunity to gauge our capabilities and support our cause if we effectively use media as a tool of communication. This is where editors have to play an important and effective role. If InnerWheel was a secret, it was because we felt that charity should not be publicized. This is inherent in cultures and religions around the world. But to do more, we need more. We need more hands. We need more funds. Today's event is an opportunity to share thoughts. It is a platform which editors have used to showcase their talents, share their ideas, their creativity, sometimes their district's works too. Editors need to be the change makers on how our organization is portrayed. By working together, we can strengthen and build the image of our activities of InnerWheel and how it enriches lives. That is what we should always do, even as a member, if not an editor. That is the purpose of the meet. I will use this opportunity to welcome past President Ebe. Thank you for putting it out, Zenny. Thank you very much. Welcome, Ebe, to the meeting. It's an honor to have you with us. Moving on. Some weeks back, I had sent out a request for club and district editors to create slogans to describe InnerWheel. When I sent out these requests and for activities, even for the centenary videos, the same thing happened. The response was lukewarm in the beginning. And then the flooding starts. I have received more than 100 slogans, which will be presented through two videos. I would like to thank and appreciate past president Nisha Gadia of my home district for helping me in this task. Thank you, Nisha. The word branding, imaging is tossed around a lot these days. InnerWheel is a huge brand, definitely. And we, the women power behind it, have done great work at achieving and building that brand. Let's build on it further. We need to be visible on an ongoing basis. Slogans describe who we are, and through this, where we are and what we do. May we have the first video of slogans, please.
Thank you.
Thank you, Rashmi. Today, we have a panel discussion between past and present IIW editors. Between us, we covered about a decade. We miss one editor though, of course. Each one of us has tried to move the organization ahead, done our bit to make us know each other better while showing our organization to the world. I'd like to introduce the panelists through a PowerPoint presentation. And may I request Nibha to highlight the panelists after I introduce. Is my screen visible? Is my screen visible?
Yes, Prabhaji, but you can make it full screen.
Yes. Yeah, I'm doing that. I'm doing the slideshow. Ashnadel Hilmi Murtagi. I think she's one of the most famous people in Innoville. In India, she's so very well known. Her desire to assist everyone across the world makes her a very favorite of all of us. She was IIW editor, media manager in 2013-14, has been a member since. Can you see how far long that is? My goodness. And she is from District 95, Egypt and Jordan, IWC, Cairo South. She has attended 9 conventions and Manchester will be her 10th. Before I was even NR, Ashnadel had been editor and I had looked at her work with awe and felt that this was a wonderful work. Very happy to have you with us, Ashnadel. Michelle was international editor when I was national representative. She comes from the Innoville Club of Ayutthaya, New Zealand, District 291, members since 2008, and she was Ed MM 2014 to 17, 3 long years to make a great change. Welcome, Michelle, great to have you. As editor, she says, you are the super connector between members and IIW. Being the IIW Ed MM, being the Ed MM was one of the most inspiring, hardest working 3 years of intense learning that she has ever encountered. Sandra. Now, Sandra was NR when I was NR. It just seems like everyone just fits into a little piece. I can recall my past. Past board director, past editor, media manager, 17, 18, 18, 19. Women's mind, she says, is her biggest strength, filled with creativity, passion, drive, and out of the box thinking, capable of achieving amazing things. That is the morale booster of the day for all of us, Sandra. Thank you. Yok San Chen, IWC IPO East District 330, and was Ed MM in the unique period, the COVID-19 years, 21-22. Yok San is my predecessor and partner, teammate in all my activities today. And yes, that's me. I've been a member of Innoville since 1989, from Innoville Club of Giridi, District 325. I was association president in 16-17 and editor, media manager, 2022-23, 2023-24. Are we all on the screen?
Yes, Prabhaji.
The topic is editors, the backroom warriors who shine a light. Backroom boys, or other ladies in this context, would refer to those whose work is not seen directly by the people, and they are warriors because of various reasons. But I think that the panelists will tell us. Let's hear what our panelists say. Ashnadel, I'll be asking all of you questions in turns and request all of you, as planned, let's have a, sorry, just a moment, please. that short answers, please. Why do you think the word backroom warriors fits us? Ashnadev.
Well, in our world, inner wheel is the star. We editors, media managers are in the background or back room, as Prabha says, making sure that when meeting the public via social media, inner wheel shines and has a lasting impact, reaching beyond posts. All necessary tools are used so that inner wheel is presented in the best possible way. Our concern should really be, where is it seen? Whom does it reach? What is its impact? Its branding, is it memorable? Is it recognizable? And does inner wheel's branding permeate social media? Dear friends, that's what we do in the back room. If successful, when the public thinks of great initiatives around the world, they will think immediately of inner wheel. Inner wheel as a far-reaching organization of dedicated women who epitomize strength and determination to achieve goals serving worldwide communities. That's what we do.
Thank you. Michelle, what is your take on this?
The background warriors, and I'd go on to say the unsung heroes, women who are working consistently behind the scenes to ensure that our image is presented to the world, that we shape and polish the content, and that it's our task to ensure that every piece that's provided is actually doing something positive to share what Inner Wheel members are doing all around the globe. No one really understands quite how much time and commitment and passion goes into the role of editor, whether it is at a club editor, district, national or international. We are constantly trying to find some way to share what we are doing. So as international editor, though, I just must add one thing. We're on duty 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Our inboxes go ping every second. The world never sleeps. So as an international editor, I had 3 years of very little sleep, but great passion and loved being that background warrior doing what we did.
Thank you. Thank you. So true. Sandra, what would you like to add?
I like to say that editors are behind the scenes heroes. Much like warriors who work tirelessly behind the scenes to safeguard their communities, editors often operate in background, unseen, but essential to the success of an organization or the project. Editors serve as the strategic communicators and brand ambassadors who for organizations that may be flying under the radar. We know that we are best kept secret in the world. To their engagement efforts, they help elevate the organization's profile, expand its reach, and build a positive reputation in the eyes of its audience. They can reinforce positive perceptions of the organization and strengthen its reputation within community. Editors play a key role in increasing the visibility and awareness of the organization's work, whether through press releases, blog posts, social media content, or through leadership articles. They help ensure that the organization message reaches its target audience and generates interest and curiosity. That's my point.
Thank you. Yuksen.
Yes.
What do you think? Backroom warriors? Does the term fit us?
I think I'm going to be the only one that's going to disagree.
I knew which is going to happen, Yuksen. That's why I repeated my question.
Well, okay. Now you asked whether, what do I think of the word warriors? Mm. Warrior to me could mean that we have an adversary or that we have a struggle or a conflict. That, and I think that that doesn't go well with what our aims are. Our aims is to promote, we are to encourage, we are to foster, and we are the good vibes people. We are the one that gives hope, we give peace, we give prayers, and we give solace to those who are experiencing trying times. We should carry ourselves with a face of kindness, generosity, and love for our fellow men. And we are blessed. I think all of us have talent, so we are blessed to empower others with knowledge, with skills and tools. And being an editor, I must say, whatever we do,
whatever we put forward, we are the face of inner wheel. And I can't imagine ourselves having a warrior face. So that's my take. Thank you.
Well, logically, although warrior would be someone engaged in a war, it is anyone who puts up a good fight, is on the job, trying to accomplish multiple tasks to portray the organization. I think that is the take the other four have versus what Yoksan has. Well, that is exactly why we need to have a panel discussion, right? I do hope you're enjoying it. You don't need, Ray Allen says, you don't need a corporation or a marketing company to brand you now. You can do it yourself. You can establish who you are with a social media. Ashnadel, social media posts make an impact, inspire others. What is your opinion?
I agree, dear Prabha. Social media has become one of the most popular ways of communication, turning our modern world into a very small global village. It's indeed a must, a daily must for people at a click of the finger. People are spending a lot more time on social media as compared to any other platform. Social media networking, online gaming, social media tools on mobile phones, communication websites. It is the fastest way of getting connected instantly, and it is expanding as we are speaking right now. This is the age of the single click. Post our 2024 centenary, the new inner wheel, as I call it, 2.0 inner wheel, can capitalize even more on its increased advantages. Global social media statistics in 2024 show more than half of the world now uses social media. That's 62.3%. 5.4 billion people around the world now use social media, with 266 million users coming in every day this year. The average daily time spent on social media is 2 hours, 23 minutes, and 94.2% of internet users now have a media identity. Everyone, imagine, 94.2 of the world has a media identity. Yeah. Of the top four social media platforms, three are owned by Meta. Facebook is the most common, followed by YouTube, WhatsApp, Instagram, TikTok, WeChat, Facebook Messenger, Telegram, Douyin, Snapchat, Meishu, Twitter, Weibo, QQ, Interest. We hold the key to how social media can best serve Inner Wheel, with a significant impact on people's lives, influencing their aspirations, their inspirations, their motivations, their likes, their interests, and their knowledge. Getting and sharing the right information is a responsibility that we all share.
Thank you. Yes, social media gives voice to voiceless peoples, whether global or local. It's where people can fight for a cause, where there is conversation, there is give and take. Ashnadel, what was the high point in your term as editor?
Oh, that was really quite interesting. We celebrated the 90th anniversary, which was a definite high point. As Inner Wheel editor, media manager, I featured all the countries and with their numerous celebrations and different identities of the celebrations. And the international outlook of Inner Wheel was really seen during that time. Another high point was We for Women. Yes, Ibi. Gabriella Adami, president at the time, was quite the dynamic visionary. She introduced the first graphic theme for international presidents. The themes started in 77 with President K. Martin from Great Britain and Ireland, and it was three words: survival, be involved. Until Carol Young from New Zealand, be a friend, we didn't have a graphic design. But Gabriella, of course, a visionary, wanted to use a graphic. This was the first one ever. And this innovative design moved Inner Wheel into the technological world of visuals, impacting content and objectives. I was very happy to use it and to encourage all the clubs and districts to use it as well.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing that with us. Thank you. Michelle, editors can open the window to the organization. Your opinion? If yes, how?
So how many times do we talk to our friends and we tell them that we're part of Inner Wheel and they say, what's that? How can we open the world? How can we open that window to let the world know who we are? We have to be out there. We have to share who we are. We have to be proud about what we're saying. If we have that window shut and the blinds down, then we're not sharing what's going on. So we need to, as editors, open the windows, blast out to the world and let them know who we are and what the good work is that we are doing, whether it's at club level, locally, nationally, internationally. Our job as editors is to ensure that the window's clean, we're branded beautifully, consistently, that we are maintaining a really good image, and that we are setting the right tone to enable the world to see who we are and what good we are doing wherever we are. So our job as editors, we're the key holder. We open that window and we push it out there and we let us shine.
Yes, of course. It is up to the editor to maximize the use of pen, print, online, electronic, social media, everything to create awareness. Another question to you, Michelle. One suggestion on how national and district editors can make their contribution more reader-friendly. Now, ladies, listen up, all the editors. We're getting a good tip here.
So we all know that when we scroll through the internet and we look on Facebook, what catches our attention? It's short, it's sharp, it's a good, clear photo, and it's really easy words to read. So Absolutely. What you need to ask is the main things is who it is that's doing the work, when they're doing it, where they're doing it, and how they're doing it. So it's just really simple. All you need is one very clear paragraph and a fantastic photo that is going to capture someone's attention. What I used to get was like 50 or 60 photos, and you then have to choose which one or two you're
things
going to
use. Things haven't changed, Michelle. Let me tell you, things haven't changed. I'm doing the sorting out even today.
So at all levels, just ask for the simple. Keep it simple. We're busy women. We just want to have our event, post something really fast.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Sandra, coming to you again. Social media posts make an impact, inspire others. Your opinion?
Yes. Social media posts indeed have the potential to make a significant impact and inspire others in various ways. And here are a few reasons why I believe so. Social media platforms have billions of users worldwide, making them powerful tools for reaching a vast audience quickly. A single post has the potential to reach millions of people across the globe, allowing messages to spread rapidly and widely. Unlike traditional media outlets, social media platforms are accessible to anyone with an internet connection. This accessibility democratizes the ability to share ideas, stories, and messages, empowering individuals and communities to have their voice heard. Social media is often used as a platform to raise awareness about important social issues, advocate for change, and mobilize support for various causes. Through compelling posts, individuals and organizations can shed light on pressing issues and galvanize others to take action. But while social media can be a powerful tool for inspiration and positive change, responsible usage and critical engagement are necessary to harness its full potential.
I thank you. As by posting, we should be inspiring others. As an aside, I find very often that members like, comment, and share only of their own club, own district, sometimes their own country. Isn't it important to see what others are doing and get inspired from it and share? Why are we restricting ourselves to our own clubs? Members, that's food for thought. Yoksan, I left all the practical questions for you. Now, all you members, 499 of us besides Yoksan, let's listen well. one suggestion from you for a good project action pick.
Okay. Well, does that mean that I have to carry an SLR camera? I think nowadays we don't do that. We carry our handphone. And that handphone today is fantastic. Can take very quick shots and we can carry it around lightly rather than those huge bulky cameras. So I would suggest if you're going to take a project action photo, be prepared. You know you're going to take photos because the project is on. Anticipate the moment. You can imagine what might happen. Oh, you might have 10 people going. You're going to a school perhaps, so you can anticipate and be prepared to take lots of shots and make sure your camera has enough memory space. Three things, okay? Prepare, anticipate, and take lots of shots, yeah? So before you take, you're going to think, how are you going to anticipate? You're going to think of 3 points. One, what's your subject of the photo? Two, what is the object? The object is actually your service, the service that's happening. So subject, the object, which is the service, and the backdrop. What is behind when you're going to take those photos? So when you're going to anticipate, sometimes you know that you're going to have 10 people attending, you know you're going to have kids in the photo, you might not have the right thing, isn't it? So you might have to more or less create the situation. You have to push people and say, okay, you sit here, you do this or you do that. Now, there's nothing wrong there. You just want a great picture, right? And you might even have to charge up the emotions. Now, what sort of emotion got to be shown? Otherwise, there's no impact. So what emotions are you looking for? Well, what is your project? You should know. Is it a crying project? Is it a project that makes everybody laugh? Ha ha, they should laugh. The mouth must be open. Or is it just smiles? Or do you expect tears? So we want emotions. Those are very impactful photos. How many of those do we see? Well, you know, you can answer that yourself. But if you can do something like that, you've got a good project action picture. So I'm going to give you two tips. Simple. Let's say if you're taking a photo with one subject or two, let the subject be a little bit off center, probably a three-quarter profile, not flat in the face. It will look, otherwise, if you take a flat one, it looks like a police lineup photo, isn't it? How many police lineup photos have we got? All our group photos are like police lineup photos. And absolutely. Of course, if you take it at the side like that, you don't look like you're taking a mug shot, isn't it? Yeah. Absolutely. Okay, that's one tip. Number two, if you have a very huge object, that's a background, like the billboard, like a signboard or something, a building, launching of a building, something like that. And you have people that you're going to take as well. So your subject is going to stand close to the camera. Don't get your subject standing close to the building because they're going to look so tiny. So that's tip number two. And that goes for our tour photos as well, okay? Not just project action, our tour photos. Can you imagine our tour photos? We are taking this beautiful scene, a building that you were visiting someplace in Paris, the Eiffel Tower. Can you imagine if the Eiffel Tower is so big and you are standing just under the Eiffel Tower? It won't work. Mm-hmm. So in other words, the tip is have your subject nearer to your camera. That's two. If you're taking a very good project photo, I can say that you take 3 seconds and you know what's the meaning of the photo. You don't need to read too much. And maybe I can share with you two photos. They were submitted for the centenary book that I'm working on. They are not that it is fantastic, but I think they are quite good. Okay, so let me see. May I share, Prabha?
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, I can share. All right. Now let's take a look at this one. I'm going to count 1, 2, three, and that's one photo. One, two, three, that's the other photo. So now I stop sharing. Okay.
Thank you.
3 seconds. Did you see what I showed?
Yes.
What do you think is the first photo? Great. Tree planting, isn't
tree
it?
Tree planting, of course.
Yeah, and you can tell.
But it showed the action.
Yeah, and the people are there and they're smiling. I don't know whether you saw that.
And the
second
emotion.
Photo, they're distributing something. Yeah, the recipient there. The person who's giving also is turning. Notice that it is not flat in the face either. So thank you, Prabha.
Thank you very much. One more question to you. Of course, you have said all that I wanted to say about pictures, and I would add just one more. No collage, please. The post pictures, she's told us about the mugshots. Please do not send us collage because it just doesn't work in a publication. Thank you. Now tell me, Yoksan, do you think editors at any level should actually edit, or should they just copy paste what comes and be done with it?
Okay. I presume we are talking about public viewing. We are not talking about private Facebook that is closed.
No.
Yes, right.
Only public viewing. Yeah.
That's right. So
what we post as an editor on the public Facebook page or whatever.
Should we edit? My answer is one word. Yes.
Thank you. Short and sweet. That's just what we wanted. Yes, editors at all levels listening to this conversation, this panel discussion, please edit so that it makes sense. Give importance to the work that is done, not importance to individuals. The organization is much bigger than the individual. And we are here to project the organization. Our time is up, my dear panelists. So even though I have another question, I'll just say it quickly, and I want all of you to give me a yes or no answer. Being tech savvy is essential today to be an editor. Yoksan?
Yes.
Yes or no answer?
Absolutely.
Sandra?
Absolutely, yes.
Ashnadel?
Absolutely.
Michelle?
Yes, and totally. Oh,
yes. We are all in unison. So no no's here. We are all on the same side. Yes, friends. It is not difficult to up your tech skills. We don't have to go to a computer class. We can just sit by ourselves and learn what to do, how to do. It just comes with experience. And even those of us who insist, I used to be called tech resistance in my family 25 years back. And now they're all very happy with me, as you can well imagine, since I have learned the ropes by myself. Thank you. Lots and lots of thanks to the panelists, of course, for being so articulate, so patient, answering the questions in a manner that everyone has loved it. Besides everything else, besides being tech savvy, it all does not mean that you forget the other essential points of editing, the three C's or the four C's: the command of language, creativity, cool-headedness. Things do come in at the last moment. I got videos even this morning. So yes, and be very careful when you're implementing it. Thank you very much, Ashnadel, Michelle, Sandra, and Yoksan, for being part of this panel. Can we have a group photograph, please, with Trish?
Just a second, Prabhaji.
Yeah.
All of you ready?
Yes.
I request everyone not to write anything in chat box
for the next 2 seconds.
Yeah, because it's pop up in the screen. Thanks for cooperating.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Now you can put us all off. Thanks for your time and all your thoughts. Yes, of course, the secret to editing is simple. The first draft is black and white, and we need to add the color. And there are deadlines to be met, so be cool-headed and do your work promptly. Dear fellow members, especially editors, every job is a self-portrait of the person who did it. Autograph it with excellence. I hope you all enjoyed the panel discussion. Now you are allowed to put your comments so that we can read it Well, we couldn't read it when we were talking. Einstein once said, creativity is contagious, pass it on. My next request to editors was an effort to find creativity. I'd asked editors to create videos that would be like advertisements for InnerWheel. We watch ads all day, every time we switch on the TV, on Facebook, on Instagram. The visual identity, the bigger picture. We should work with media and social media to pitch stories. We need to create content that can be shared and viewed. Now watch the creativity of our members. There is no lack of talent or innovative ideas. Rashmi, please share the compiled video.
Hello to all dynamic women in the world. Let me tell you something about InnerWheel. InnerWheel, which started as a small reunion of 26 Rotarian women, is today a global organization of inspiring, enthusiastic individuals who want to make a difference for all women in the world. Service for education, parenting, care, support, we make it work. And the friendship among InnerWheel friends is unique. Would you like to gain instantly 100,000 friends? Come with me and discover how InnerWheel provides a platform to do something for unprivileged women. Join us, and together we shape a better future.
International InnerWheel, you know, let's see. Beta, play, 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 gidida, horo, que, boro, bell, bime. I have a ton, a canton, a fo, roto, can we come? Yonu, ting, beju, ever me, boro, jabando, ni no me dag be, yonu le, podo, fiero, hudo, tomelepo, mi wanu, mi no, bo, locutano, si, beta, me, bona motendo, na wa chiche. Nona, dagbe po yonu enele po fi enele po edo po yobi se se me edo ta jo edo bene jio bene to mi to me on atama chio onu e InnerWheel.
InnerWheel gives vocational training to empower the needy women.
And we have the blog for some certain sizes. And we cut the paper according to the size of this blog.
So we block small in the ఒక్కొక్క దానికి ఒక్కొక్క సైజ్. సో ఈ బ్లాక్ పెట్టి
நல்லா இருக்கா
Educate, empower, come on.
If we have stayed in that center, then we can find classes and all such things.
InnerWheel brightens everybody's lives.
Not too late, together we can change the world. Lay the puzzle pieces out, find out what it's all about. Together we can change the world.
Club name is Golf Ring Ghazebar 3301. Introducing InnerWheel, a global organization dedicated to empower communication and changing lives. At InnerWheel, we promote friendship, encourage, and personal service to foster international understanding. Join us, make a difference, volunteer your time, and donate to support our projects. Projects like animal welfare, family welfare, special education. Be honest, be kind, be the reason someone smiles. Thank you.
Zombe dunwa we visana sa fa point iner wille ya laram taba zour point la nata musi la raye point mpa mon songer ma bi procé et pourtant pas et compoule na nibla ni sa fa un telepton masm et nataba watir kolom sam nuga yemre iner wille club zour point mpa man pouk andra na yelen song ne ba fa santar namso yira irma bi posa ir kompulwa ir wili tab no ngolam ne songor po
Hundred years of achievement, 100 years of admiration, 100, 100, away till the 100, 100.
everyone. Welcome to my kitchen of growth. I am your chef, Vishali Bard, and today I will show you the perfect recipe to embody the most adept and admirable version of yourself. This recipe was originally brought up by Margaret Golding 100 years ago. This recipe has always been special because of its secret potion, Inner Wheel Club. Ingredients we need are goal setting, curiosity, acknowledgement, and space to make a lots of frames.
Inner Wheel Club will let you meet the best version of you by developing leadership, teamwork, and communication skills. Not only that, this recipe as its secret portion will be based on friendship locally to globally, love and support.
That's it. Inner Wheel Club will provide you a platform to make a change that matters.
International Inner Wheel Club, je kulu dumamba mi filinu jine fanta ani flabera. Ka ben sabati muso. Ani yonche ka kanu sabati muso ni yonche ani ka deme yala ka di desebato muso ani jemson ni muso ni kanu bi jusura ni bi fe ka do ni je kulu man bana wal ma ka deme la fe ka di desebato ma ibi se kan yala na page Facebook wal ma kan solo ni nge kurenga 70 24 79 26 Inner Wheel Club International. Ka ben sabati muso ni yonche. Ka deme yala ka di dese bato. Muso ani demson anayin wanaoma. Merci.
Inner Wheel Naman. The Inner Wheel Club is a vibrant community organization dedicated to friendship, promoting personal development and making a positive impact in our local communities. As a part of global network, Inner Wheel Club spanning over 100 countries, our members have access to wealth of resources, idea and support. If you are passionate about making difference, building meaningful relationship, we invite you to explore a world of Inner Wheel and join us on our journey of service, friendship and empowerment. Together we can create a brighter future for all. Thank you.
Hello everybody, this is Anita Meerink. I am currently president of Inner Wheel the Netherlands. As you see, I am not in your meeting, I am somewhere else. But I thought the questions were interesting ones because I think it's all depending on the role you have as Inner Wheel in the country where you are working, because the role is everywhere different in the world. For instance, in the Netherlands, we are beside fundraising and hands-on projects, we do also a lot of awareness. Besides that, what we also do, what we try to do, is that we let the good causes we support tell about us. So we don't do like tell ourselves how wonderful and how much work we did. We tell people, but we ask our causes to tell about what we did for them. And with that, you work together with the causes, and it might be less being very, very bragging about how well you did, which fits our interview a lot, I think. Have a good meeting, and thank you very much. Bye. See you in Manchester, I hope.
Hi. Do you really want to make a difference to society and enjoy fellowship while doing service? In that case, Inner Wheel, our vibrant global organization of dynamic women across the world, supporting each other to win across future-ready initiatives, is just the right choice for you. So what are you waiting for? Join Inner Wheel today and infuse your life with a sense of purpose and energy.
Hi, my name is Leslie Shaw, and I'm a member of a women's service organization called Inner Wheel. My club helps local charities and raises money for our national foundation, which provides myoelectric prosthetics at no cost to disadvantaged children with upper limb loss. These programs help make our community stronger and better. But we're also part of an amazing sisterhood of more than 100,000 women around the globe who are using their time and talents to improve our neighborhoods, our countries, our world. We'd love for you to join us. Inner Wheel, united in friendship and service.
Il club Inner Wheel di Foligno, distretto 209 Italia, aura, sincerità, amore, difesa, legame, fiducia. In una sola parola, amicizia. Buon anniversario!
Hi. Are you a woman who is compassionate about helping the needy in the society? Are you that woman who is selfless and ready to make a change in helping the less privileged in the society? Are you that woman who is ready to share your time, your talent, and your treasure in helping the less privileged? Then, International Inner Wheel Club is a place for you to be. Come, join us at International Inner Wheel Club, where we help the needy, where we reach out to the less privileged in our society to make it a better place. Come, we are waiting. Thank you.
Inner Wheel includes everyone.
In Inner Wheel, all our programs, events, and meetings begin with the candle of friendship. Through Inner Wheel, I have made friends not only within the club, but with members of clubs around the world.
A happy hand is what we provide, and these are the little things that we do with love.
The one thing that attracted me to Inner Wheel Club is that a successful team is a group of many hands and one mind. Teamwork.
If you like dressing up, traveling, having fun, join us in Inner Wheel. We have it all. Hope to see you soon.
When Inner Wheel women come together, amazing things happen. We uplift each other, inspire change, and create opportunities. Inner Wheel, it's where sisterhood, friendship, teamwork, and service work wonders. Come join the Centennial International Club Inner Wheel to make a difference.
When you go to heaven, you have a ticket next to all of the world, but Inner Wheel, some of the world.
Il club Inner Wheel di Foligno, distretto 209 Italia, aura, sincerità, amore, difesa, legame, fiducia. In una sola parola, amicizia. Buon anniversario!
Are you the woman of new generation looking for an international platform to network and serve the community all over the world? Then Inner Wheel is the right choice for you.
Are you a retired female professional with enough time in hand, wanting to give back to society all that you enjoyed in your lifetime? Then Inner Wheel is the right place for you.
Hey, are you a homemaker searching for more meaningful life? Then Inner Wheel is the right place for you, dear.
Are you lonely, looking for an extended family of compassionate women? Then Inner Wheel will bring joy to your life.
Join Inner Wheel and love Inner Wheel.
Thank you.
Thank you, Rashmi. Thank you very much. Wasn't that lovely? Everyone really surprised me with their inputs, and I wasn't expecting this kind of a response or this kind of innovation. Thank you so much to all the participants. I think most of the board directors are highlighted. Maybe some are missing. I can see only a few of you. Michelle, Cynthia, Kamal Prabha, Dorothy, Marlish. And I saw a few more, but I can't see them now. Welcome. Thank you very much for being with us and giving us a moral boost. Thank you. Sandra, I missed out on asking you something. Maybe I should do it right away now. Is Sandra around? Can I get her on?
Yes, Sandy.
Yes. Sandra, now that you're here and we've seen this, could you tell me whether this is what editors can do? Open the window to the organization in various ways. Do you think this is possible?
Yes, it is possible, absolutely. An editor can indeed open the window on their organization in several ways. They play a crucial role in communicating the organization mission, values, and objectives through the content they curate and publish. They foster engagement and interaction with the organization audience through various channels, such as websites, social media, newsletters, and publications. They can encourage dialogue, feedback, and participation, creating a sense of community in connection around the organization. That's the essential. Editors ensure that the organization message is conveyed clearly and effectively to its audience. They have a deep understanding of the organization's goals, values, and key messages, and then translate this into compelling content that resonates with the target audience. Overall, editors serve as gatekeepers and storytellers for the organization, shaping its public image and narrative through the content they produce. By leveraging their skills, creativity, and platform effectively, they can open the window to the organization, okay, offering audience a clear view of its values and impact.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So this is our little attempt to open the world of InnoWheel to the world outside. Thank you, Sandra.
Thank you.
InnoWheel is our platform to express ourselves, to do what we want, the way we want. And that is what we have done here since school and college. Most of the time, there is so much written on social media, but not necessarily of interest. Pitch InnoWheel to the best of your abilities. National editors have debated on the topic. Editors are image builders of InnoWheel. I got 6 entries. I've got 6 entries, 4 for the motion and 2 against. So it is now as 2 for and 1 against will be coming together. May I have the video, please? 2 came as text and PPT. I express my gratitude to past district chairman Dinaz Tarapur of district 313. Rashmi, just wait, pause. Of district 313 and past association treasurer Archana Agarwal of 312 for becoming the voices of the script and the PPT to present the arguments. Please begin. Thank you. Yeah, it's coming.
Hello, friends. My name is Mary Bernadette Pangulayan. I'm the national editor of the InnoWheel Clubs of the Philippines Incorporated. I am a member of the InnoWheel Club of San Francisco Del Monte, and I joined InnoWheel in 1984, which means that I've been a member for 30 years now. Now, I am for the position that the editor is the image builder or an image builder of the InnoWheel Club. Why? First, the editor is instrumental in defining and maintaining a consistent brand across all content or across all audiences. We make sure that whatever content is put out reflects the values, the mission, the personality, and the culture of our organization. We also are responsible for producing high quality, error-free, and engaging content which reflects well on the organization. And when we do this, we are set apart from all the other organizations like us. The editor also can tell stories about the organization through the experiences, the challenges, even the impact of the club or the organization on its community, on its country. What else? The editor also manages public relations. So we have editors who put out blogs, who put out social media content through website, through Facebook, through Instagram, etc. The editor also can put out written press releases. Now, when we say that the editor is an image builder, we should make sure that the editor is consistent across all channels, whether it's on written form or whether it's on social media or online form. Through information and the informative content, the editor can establish the organization as a leader in the industry or as a leader in its own right. And the editor is responsible for compiling all these articles and all these written forms by the clubs and the districts and making sure that the organization is well represented. I think that's about it. So we will see you, everybody, we will see you, especially you, International Inner Wheel Editor, Prabha, on March 27 for the actual debate. Thank you. Have a good day. Goodbye.
Warm Inner Wheel greetings to all my esteemed Inner Wheel members. As the National Editor of Association of Inner Wheel Clubs in India, it's my privilege to welcome you all to this insightful webinar. Today, we delve into a crucial aspect of our organization, the pivotal role of editors as image builders of Inner Wheel. Editors serve as the architects of our narrative, shaping perceptions and amplifying our mission on a global scale. Together, let us explore how we can further enhance our impact through effective editorial practices. Dear friends, editing is not just about fixing mistakes. It's all about refining the raw material into something polished and profound. Editors play a very significant role as the image builder of Inner Wheel, meticulously shaping and refining content to reflect the organization's value and mission. Through their skilled craftsmanship, they ensure that the messages conveyed are impactful, clear, and resonate with the audience, ultimately strengthening the organization's presence and reputation. With skillful precision, editors construct the foundation of Inner Wheel's presence, preparing it for its branding. Editors weave the threads of Inner Wheel's essence into a tapestry of inspiration. Editors are not just wordsmiths, they are visionaries who paint a vivid picture of Inner Wheel's impact, inspiring others to join in our collective journey towards a better world. So at the end, would like to say a good editor is someone who knows when to stand back and let the leaders shine, and when to step in and polish the diamond and build the image of Inner Wheel. Enjoy friendship, enjoy Inner Wheel, long live Inner Wheel.
President Trish and Inner Wheel friends, I'm speaking against the motion. Editors are image builders of Inner Wheel. I want to remind you that editors are gatekeepers of content, not strategists. Our primary function is to ensure accuracy and clarity and maintain the authenticity of the message, not to craft or alter the organization's image. Image refers to the general impression that a person or organization presents to the public. I've become cynical. The image of celebrities and organizations are often proven to be paper thin or false. So if I could change the editor's traditional job description, I'm convinced that it would be a mistake, as I believe that an editor already has an important role. It encompasses copy, paste, post, and a sprinkle of commas. But chiefly, our role is to shine a light. We must shine a light on the wonders worked at all levels in our organization, to reflect on what ordinary members, who are all extraordinary women, achieve with an Inner Wheel. With every issue of our national magazine, I strive to tell these stories. As Inner Wheel women learn about their community and the world, they find the need and respond. They conjure up piles of knitting, beanies for ambulance services, tiny garments for the neonatal unit. They sew dresses for girls in the Pacific. They visit housebound members. They walk and talk and build friendships. They celebrate Inner Wheel and laugh a lot. The newsletters are really about the office bearers. They are for and about the woman who turn up and set up, remember to bring the milk, who phone a friend in need, who bring the biscuits. Our job is to give these women a place where their story is told, to remind them that what they do has great value. If what I do as an editor contributes to Inner Wheel's image of being a caring organisation, then I'm okay with that. But I want it to be incidental and not the focus of what I do. When Margaret Golding started Inner Wheel 100 years ago, she had no interest in building an image. Instead, she set to work. And as an editor, this is what I want to honor.
Good morning from Palm Harbor, Florida. My name is Leslie Shaw, and I'm the national editor for Inner Wheel USA and the district editor for District 696 here in the United States. We have been asked to share our opinion about whether we as Inner Wheel editors are image builders or if our responsibility is only to share the information provided to us by club members and district leaders. I spent the first 20 years of my career working as a newspaper reporter and copy editor here in the Tampa Bay area. I'm sure that everyone attending this meeting is an excellent editor, but that does not necessarily mean they enjoy interviewing people or writing stories. Those are two very different jobs. But because of my experience in the news business, being able to write stories again, especially about an organization I care very deeply about, is why I asked to be considered for the editor's position. As a journalist, I love a good story. And there are so many good stories to tell about Inner Wheel. As an editor, I believe it is my job to oversee the content and the quality of what I put in our newsletter, both the written word and the images I choose. I don't just take the quarterly reports given to me by clubs and districts and retype them into the newsletter. I also do not publish every photograph that is sent to me. One or two crisp, captivating photographs are so much better, in my opinion, than 12 very similar photographs of the same event. If someone emails me about a unique service project in New York or a walkathon in California that raised $4,000 in one day, I ask who I should call to get more information. Sometimes I communicate with members via email, and sometimes I will just call them, whichever they prefer. By doing so, I not only create a much more interesting story, I also can make a new friend. Our newsletters and social media efforts give a voice to InnerWheel. They demonstrate who we are, what we do, and why people should care and join our efforts. It should help us feel more strongly connected to one another. That's why InnerWheel news editors should try to use newsletters as a vehicle to celebrate our friendships, highlight our successes, and inspire visitors to attend one of our meetings. If you don't feel comfortable writing your own story about an InnerWheel service project or unique club member, I totally understand. It takes time and effort, but I would encourage you to realize the significant impact your role can have on promoting InnerWheel worldwide. I applaud each of you for taking on this responsibility and sharing your creativity with our organization. Warm regards, Leslie.
Good morning. I'm reading out the matter from the PPT presentation of National Media Manager and Editor, Belgium, Luxembourg, Daisy Lace Grillet, club name Antwerpen Busy Metropole, District 217, year of joining InnerWheel 2003. Editors, the architects of the soul's reflection. An editor can certainly be a source of inspiration for innovation. Editors play an important role in selecting and designing content and can provide new ideas and perspectives that lead to innovative and surprising creations. They can also provide feedback and suggestions for improvement, encouraging club editors and creators to break new ground and refine their work. In addition, editors often have broad knowledge of the field and the market, which allows them to identify trends and opportunities for innovation. In short, a good editor can certainly play an inspiring role and contribute to innovation in the creative sector. Editors can shape and improve the image of a person or company through their work. They can refine content, improve grammar and style, and ensure consistency and accuracy in a piece of text. In a broader sense, editors can help create a coherent whole and a graph brand image through the material they edit, such as marketing materials, website content, or social media posts. By carefully editing and refining content, editor can help build a positive and professional image for their members. The question is, why did I want to be my country's editor? Well, it has always been part of my career. Passion for language and writing. I love playing with words, grammar and style since I was young. It gives me the opportunity to use my creativity and language skills to improve and perfect text. Interest in different topics. As an editor, we can work on a wide range of topics depending on the type of publication we work on. This can vary from news, fashion and lifestyle to science, history and literature. Improving texts. As an editor, we help authors to make their text more effective and convincing. We can structure the text, correct factual errors, adjust the tone, and improve the style so that it better suits the intended purpose and public. Opportunities for growth and development. As editor, we often work together with other professionals such as writers, journalists, and designers. This offers me the opportunity to expand my network, learn new skills, and continue to develop myself. In short, being an editor is a challenging and fascinating choice because I love language and creativity. It is more than a passion. It's love for language, for improving and embellishing texts, and to play with images, colors, and all the creative possibilities nowadays. So yes, we can build the image through what we do. Creativity, freedom is ours. Yes, An editor can play a significant role in improving a brand company. An editor can ensure that all written content from advertising copy to website text to social media posts is clear, concise and engaging. This can also help maintain a consistent tone and style throughout all communications, helping to build a strong and brand image. Thank you.
The sound is not coming. Is it paused? Rashmi, just forward it a bit and see. No? Go back a bit. Go back a bit. Start, huh?
Communications helping to build a strong and
this is done. This is done. Close it. I'll put the last bit myself. I'll share the audio in a minute. Please stop screen share. That was an audio and I had put it together, but unfortunately I can't find it here. Let me just put it immediately. Can you hear? This will only be an audio, so please listen to it. Is it audible? Can somebody answer me?
No.
This is not Sama Prabha.
Prabhaji, kindly click the start button. I think it's not started yet.
No.
No, it has started. I can hear it. So
okay.
Just a moment. I probably need to go to the, 1 second, the sound part. I'll just drop this for a moment and sending it to Rashmi. Or maybe shall I send it to you, Nibha?
Yes, you can. Please.
We'll do it after the next. I'm sorry for this glitch, but technology sometimes does cause hassles for us. So I'll put this audio in 5 minutes. It is interesting. And I think our opinions are more clouded than clear because all of them have been expressing the opinions so well. In the meantime, we will go. Thank you very much. So Mary, Sonal, Hani, Carmelina, Lizle, and Daisy. The next, maybe have the second video of slogans while I get the audio of the last speaker going again. Maybe have the video, Rashmi, please. Thank you, Rashmi. Publicity, imaging, branding, whatever the word, are we expecting to position ourselves like MACD, Colgate with king-size hoardings, ad jingles and paid brand ambassadors? Should they remember our work, the jingle or pretty face, and to what end? But to grow, we need to show ourselves. And that's what our members' creativity needs to be applauded for creating slogans and posters to show what we are. Thanks a lot to all of you who sent it. There were 130 that were shown, and there are still a few more in my mailbox, which I couldn't include. Thank you very much for the fantastic participation. When we were in school and college, JAM, just a minute speech contests were a hit. In the time span of 1 minute, can you put forth your views convincingly? Here we have district editors doing just that on the topics. Either an editor needs to be creative or challenges social media presented to me. May we have the compilation, please?
An editor is like a photographer who captures a landscape to show and hide that has not seen it. An Inavil editor is to show the life-changing work done by her club to the world, spreading joy. Peace is hanging by a thread and hope is at an all-time low. This is need for a strong message that drives the importance of action rather than words. This is why our theme for 2023-24 is Shine a Light. As Inavil continues to shine a light in our community, it is very important that the editor uses innovative, creative and vivid ways to project this action to the world. Therefore, an editor has the purpose of creating a diamond out of a rough stone. Thank you.
Namaste to all. My tributes to the founder, Mrs. Margaret Oliver Gould. The seed sown by her has grown into a big banyan tree, giving shelter to the needy and the underprivileged all around the world. The responsibility of bringing to the limelight the service projects done by the clubs vests in the hands of the editors. Benjamin Franklin says, either write something worth reading or do something worth writing. This is the key message to the editors. An editor has to be creative as to captivate the reader's attention to the subject published in a book or social media. Attractive posters, interesting videos, unique articles of little known facts can be tools to make known to the public the dedication with which the organization works. Curious captions, colorful segmentation, refreshing crossword puzzles related to the subject matter can be promising inducers to read through. Designing a bulletin, a souvenir, or posting in social media is a platform to the editors to exhibit their artistic skills. Thanks to Prabhaji for giving us this platform to share our views.
Hi, I'm Shongita Mukherjee, District Editor of District 329. Now I share my thought about the challenges social media presented for me. The social media opened the whole world for us, but the challenges I face in social media to get the correct information. A lot of fake and fabricated substances are talking rounds. It sometimes become difficult to filter the fake from the truth and the biased opinion, which look pretty convincing and at times. Moreover, it is addiction which harms us the most, which enables one to live life along barring friends and relatives. It keeps you engaged in unfruitful things, basically to pass the time instead of utilizing that time more effectively. Though I would like to conclude my speech on a positive note. Everything in social media is not bad, but if used responsibly with ethics, honesty and sincerity, then it has a lot of potential to make our life better than before. Thank you.
My topic is an editor needs to be creative. A district editor must be interactive and up to date with modern media and the technology, as well as graphic design and connecting with all members. District 95, founded in 1921, has had brilliant editors over the years. During my tenure, we started publishing 3 digital magazines for all for the year, but also have a printed issue at the end of the year. That includes all the projects and activities of the district and the clubs. We are also creating a small booklet for the Manchester Convention, and one of its highlights is our environment project. I try to make the material that I publish interesting, organized, and meaningful with a human dimension, and not just a mere narration of the details of a project or event. Using creative graphics and the right combinations of colors and the good selections of actions, photos make posts interesting and creative. An inner wheel editor must captivate her readers' attention, have them look forward to her posts and publications. Finally, thank you for your attentions, and to use Praha's special words, every member is an ambassador of inner wheel. Shine a light on all you do.
Hello everyone, I am Smita Biani, district editor of 304. I am from the heart of India, MP. The topic that I have chosen for today is an editor. Needs to be creative. An editor turns boring piece of information into interesting topic. Also an editor enhances the quality and clarity of the text and helps the reader to stay on it for a longer period. An editor must be able to provide proper insight into how the story must be told to the readers by improving the structure and flow of the content. An editor must take the feedback more positively and have an open mind, inputs and ideas. Creativity can become a greatest weapon when it is in the hands of an editor. Any problem that lands on an editor's table can be knocked off with a touch of creativity. Within a short period, from creating joyful activities for women around the world, establishing stronger bonds with other people, creative editor can play a vital role. Thus, an editor needs to be creative. Thank you.
Hi everybody, I'm district editor Jessica Woon of District 332, Singapore. As you know, our district was newly formed, and I have had the privilege and honor to serve as the district editor for the past 2 years. It's been a really exciting and interesting experience with the formation of the district and getting to know even more friends and forming many wonderful friendships. And I thank you for this opportunity, and I will see you around.
Thank you for providing us with this beautiful opportunity to express our views. The bulletin editor serves as the custodian of communication, the weaver of narratives, and the architect of connection within our inner wheel community. Hence, creativity should be the driving force behind every editorial decision, as they infuse every page with energy, personality, and flair. In today's world, where technology has bestowed upon us a wealth of tools and resources to unleash our creativity like never before, let us not squander these opportunities. My friends, homogeneity and self-doubt are creativity's worst enemies. So let's banish these doubts.
Our core values of originality and diversity. Let us dare to think outside the box and redefine what it means to be an editor in our innovative community. For in the end, it is our creativity that will set us apart and define our legacy.
Greetings. This is Neelu Walia, District Editor, District 308, India. In today's digital world, social media is crucial for innovative district editors. However, it brings unique hurdles like content management, content creativity, brand consistency, platform diversity, website maintenance, privacy and security, keeping up updated, time constraints, negative feedback, language and cultural sensitivity. While social media poses challenges, we as district editors can overcome them by setting goals, understanding our audience, collaborating, staying informed, and adapting to changes. By doing so, we can harness the power of social media to advance InnoWheel's mission of service and friendship. Thank you.
Hi, this is Hemlata Mani, District Editor, InnoWheel District 323. Challenges social media presented for me. This is the topic I chose. For me, the greatest challenge was to preserve photograph of the daily projects from the Trailblazer presidents. More than considering it as challenge, it became my daily routine to showcase the projects in district websites, Facebook and Instagram pages. Have been constantly updated with district events and club projects. Every month, club projects were compiled and sent to the national editor to be published in the association and international Facebook pages. It's my privilege to be an district editor in this centennial year of the prestigious District 323.
Thank you, Rashmi. Well done, district editors. Actions speak louder than words. And for that, action has to be creative, continuous, consistent, and impacting our society persistently. Now we will have our last debater, Kamalina, speaking live. I'm spotlighting her and asking her to unmute. Please unmute. Can you unmute, ask her to unmute, please? Are you able to see that? Nibha?
Yes, that I'm sending prompt.
Sending a prompt to her. Yes, now she's clear. Now. Yeah, please.
Okay. My name's Carmelina Caffiero. Good morning, everybody. And I am national editor Italian, of course, club Brindisi Cristina Cordella, district 210. Okay, the question related to the national editors was, are the national editors image builders of the inner wheel? And I answered in this way. I have to answer that I do not find myself in the fourth category, that is to say in the group of the national editors able to use while fulfilling their tasks, both creativity and freedom. Unfortunately, I must take it against stand this is not we are able to do, because there is a no room for our creativity and freedom in what we are required to do in our work. Being a national editor in Italy, according to the bylaws of 2023, national standing orders, that is to say, I am in charge of publishing all that is relating to the governing body. For example, the articles relating to the events the national Italian president takes part and so on. All this said, I do hope things can really change in the near future. I would like to say about today. That I feel very happy for this opportunity, which gave us to meet, to get to know one another, and to be able to create a great team, starting from the club and the district and the national editors. Moreover, the chance of meeting you and International Inner Wheel Media Manager gives me a great joy. And the participation of the International President, Trish Douglas, today is the icing on the cake, representing all that is positive for me from this moment on. And this meeting is a testimonial of the cooperation spirit of our members who will take part in the convention with a great number. Those are showing the need of maintaining meaningful and significant relationship with the international community. Today, I am very happy, and today I can say that I am full from this moment on. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Today we have members attending from 32 to 34 countries and regions, and some which comprise several countries actually. I'm going to quickly name those who confirmed. My apologies if I miss out any, please put your name on the chat box if I miss. Australia, Austria and Czech Republic, Belgium and Luxembourg, Central Africa, Croatia, Denmark, Egypt and Jordan, FAMAT, Finland, GBNI, Germany, India, Reunion and Madagascar, Italy, Malaysia, Mexico, Nepal, New Zealand, Nigeria, northern part of Cyprus, Norway, Pakistan, Philippines, Singapore, Sri Lanka, Sweden, Turkey, USA, West Africa, that's actually four countries probably, Netherlands. Among the non-districted clubs, Trinidad and Tobago, Lusaka, Slovenia, I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right, Ljubljana and Banja Luka from Bosnia and Herzegovina. That is a bit overwhelming for me, definitely, and it's most unexpected. I now request IIW President Trish to address the gathering. Let's hear her views about our efforts.
Wow. Good morning to you all. And I'm looking at the screen and we have got 356 people who are viewing this morning. I have got to say, I am absolutely delighted, Prabha, for your presentation and program this morning to the global editors. And for those of us who are not technically minded, I am at the top of that particular tree. I do my very best to answer all the emails that I receive. But I want to thank you and Yuxan for all that you're doing for the convention. And it is a great honor that we have got to be able to host in Manchester. And I thank you on behalf of the executive and the governing body. And I know that we've got quite a few board directors with us this morning, and I am delighted that they've been able to join us. And also to Phyllis and Ash Nadell, I had this vision, and all of us do have our concept of Inner Wheel. And that, yes, we, in the past at convention, we've had a house of friendship, but I wanted a house of culture because we are multicultural. And I wanted to bring the flavor of all our countries into the convention in Manchester, which is our 19th convention. And not only that, it's a big, huge celebration from around the world. And they have done immense work, these two girls, to bring the House of Culture to life. And with your help, we will do just that. I have had the most amazing time in the countries I have visited. Finland, Sweden, Denmark, France, Norway, India, South and North, the Philippines, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Pakistan, France, Romania, Croatia. No, I haven't been to Croatia. Apologies. I am going there in June. And Romania and Bulgaria. All of you have accepted me for who I am. And that is great. You've also appreciated the fact that I am a very hands-on president. I like to see all that you're doing. I like to ensure that it's great that you are using my theme of shine a light around the world. Also, not only that, you are brightening lives for the future, which is absolutely amazing. And also wellness brightens lives. And when I talk about wellness brightens lives, I am thinking the street children that I have seen selling balloons at 10 o'clock at night. And in a wheel, we are there educating these street children. And that is, to me, the best thing that we can do. Also, teaching and dancing and singing with all of the children that I have met, children that actually have no hearing and were sign languaging. And it was just amazing that we are giving these children the opportunity that we do to bring them together in a school so that we can give them the best life that they can have. Also, we look after the poor. I have been into villages where you are distributing food, you're distributing clothing, and the name of Inner Wheel, believe you me, is out there. It's been absolutely fantastic. Brighten lives for the future. You're doing that all over the world by doing all the planting that you do, all the fields that I've walked through, all the forests that you are doing. It's fantastic. It's the oxygen that we need in the air so that we can give a planet, extend our planet to our children's children, our grandchildren, their children. We won't see this, but we have got to keep the planet going. All of us know there is huge climate change, and every individual, we have got to make sure that we do our very best. Remember also about the creatures of our earth. We've only got 4% of wild animals that should not be. They should be free. We should be helping the growth of our animal kingdom. We have got to do this. I also feel that we do communicate around the world. And for the first year, this year, we have a communications committee headed up by Marlise, Michelle, Dorothea and Manta. And they have been helping Yuxan with their centenary book. And for her, she is doing just such great work. And Prabha, you have raised the stakes very, very high indeed. And you have done an amazing 2 years. And I applaud you for all the work that you have done. We've got a wonderful convention, and I've got to thank the LCC for pulling it together and overseeing every step of the way. There is one thing that I really, really am very passionate about, and I want to put the record straight. Foundation. I would very, very much like to see a foundation for Inner Wheel. We need a foundation, and I know there is opposition. but I want to give the right message out. The message is not the fund would be kept by paid people and not by the executives and the board directors. That which is going around in Zoom meetings around the world is certainly not true. I think the people who are opposing the foundation, please can they step back? Because they do not know what we're bringing into the convention this year. And I feel the foundation has got to be given the heads up. We need a foundation because all the time we ask you for money. When there's something that's happening in the world, we say, give us some money. We need to act. We need to act very promptly. We need to be able to do it immediately. And I'm incredibly passionate about this. But please come into the convention with a very, very open mind about the foundation. Because what you are hearing is not what we are saying. And I would like to put that record straight away. It would be a great thing if we had our own foundation. And the foundation will not be run by the executive or the board directors, but it would be run by trustees, as all foundations are. But please give it a chance. Come and listen to the arguments. And also remember, girls, if we don't do this, we have to wait another 3 years. The children on the street selling balloons will no longer be there. We won't be able to help the deaf children that we've been given braille machines to, so that they can actually earn a living. Just think of your own country. Just think of what you do. Just think globally what we all can do. And I am so delighted to be able to speak to you all today. I have not had this opportunity. I have been going from country to country, speaking of how I feel about Brighton Lives for the Future and Wellness Brightens Lives. And I thank you all so much for using Shine a Light everywhere around the world. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart for all that you do. You editors are all amazing. You are getting the word out there. And we will come together. We are better together. And I do believe that might be something that Phyllis, as an international past president, I think she said, we are better together. And I use that as well. We are better together. We need to shine our light. We do shine a light. But girls, I congratulate each and every one of you for all that you do for Innerwheel. Thank you so much.
Thank you, President Trish. You have been such a motivating, supporting person to all of us. You shine a light and we try to pass it along. Thank you very much. We all dream, and this song is an all-time favorite. A little dance as we move towards the end by the members of District 325. Rashmi, can we have the video, please?
I have a dream.
I would like to recognize and appreciate District 325 EC members. Nibha, please highlight them. District Chairman Ragini, perhaps she's not with us. District Chairman Elect Alakananda Bakshi. Vice Chairman Anjana Poddar. AC member Rita Jha. District Secretary Rashmi. District Treasurer Priyaka. District ISF Nibha herself, and District Editor Shubhra. Without your cooperation, this event would not have happened. Thank you very much, my dear girls. I would also like to recognize past Association Treasurer Archana. I think she's left. And Dinaz, I highlighted her. Tarapur, past President Nisha Gadia, maybe highlight her, please, who all assisted wholeheartedly the moment I asked for help. Thank you. You can remove the highlights now, Nibha. It's Ramadan month, Easter week. Celebration of Holi happened 2 days back, and the spring equinox Navroz of Zoroastrians last week. As Innerwheel members, we all stand for peace and international understanding. We finished the event with prayers for peace, a compilation by my home club with assistance from other Innerwheel friends. May we have the video, Rashmi?
Make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is discord, harmony. Where there is error, truth. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that I may know so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born into eternal life.
Ashem vahu vaishtem asti ushta asti ushta amai yatashai vaishtai ashem.
In righteousness, ashoi, lies real happiness, for it is God's finest gift. Happiness is his who is righteous, for true righteousness is sake.
Namya harenge kyo, namya harenge kyo, namya harenge kyo.
May all beings everywhere plagued with sufferings of body and mind quickly be freed from illnesses. May those who find themselves in trackless, fearful wilderness, the children, the aged, the unprotected, be guarded by angels, and may they swiftly attain Buddhahood.
Namya harenge kyo,
Namya Harenge Kyo. Namya Harenge Kyo.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qul Huwallahu Ahad. Allahu Samad. Lam Yalid. Walam Yulad. Walam Yakullahu. Kufuwan Ahad. This chapter of the Quran is about the oneness of God. The concept of God has been presented here in its purest form, ridding it of all polluting associations which people of every age have brought to it. There is no plurality of gods. There is only one God. All are dependent upon Him, but He is not dependent on anybody. He Himself has power over everything.
आ तुझे अंतर में शांति मिलेगी सुख कली खिलेगी कि पर में कहीं शांति नहीं शुद्धात्म को निरख ले सब भ्रांति टलेगी सुख कली खिलेगी कि पर में कहीं शांति नहीं हाँ तुझे अंतर में शांति मिलेगी सुख कली खिलेगी
वाहेगुरु जी एक ओंकार वाहेगुरु जी की फतेह श्री भगवती सहवार श्री भगवती जी के पास है दसवीं कीर्तन भगवती सिमर के गुरु नानक ले आए फिर हंगत गुरु ते अमरदास राम दास से हो साय अर्जन हर गुण नो सिमरो श्री हर राय श्री हर कृष्ण त्याये जिस तीर्थे सब दुख चाहे तेग बहादुर सिमरिय कार नौनित दावे थे सब थाए हो साय दसा पासा श्री गुरु गोबिंद सिंह जी महाराज पंथ देवाली सब थाए हो साय दसा पासा यदि ज्योत श्री गुरु ग्रंथ साहिब जी पार दर्शन दीदार दा ध्यान तार के खालसा जी साहब बोलो जी वाहेगुरु वाहेगुरु वाहेगुरु
संगच्छध्वं संबदध्वं संवो मनां सिजानतां समानो मंत्र समिति समानी समानं मनः सहजित मेषा
थैंक यू रश्मि आई वुड नाउ रिक्वेस्ट एशनडेल टू टेल अस अ बिट अबाउट द हाउस ऑफ कल्चर शी वांटेड टू शेयर समथिंग विद अस
If I may, thank you for giving me the time, but I'd like to ask the countries that did not send any pictures for the film we are doing for the House of Culture. It is late, it is too late after the deadline, but I'm willing to extend a few more days so that your country, I don't want to put you on the spot and say who did not send, either non-districted clubs or other countries. Even though the national representatives and the board directors have worked very hard to ask clubs to send contributions. So it's not too late. Please do send me. Everyone has my email. Send me more pictures, but pictures not of people standing like a lineup, but pictures of your country, the soul of your country, the scenery, the touristic sites, cultural sites, so that your country can be really visited in the convention by seeing the film we are producing. Please do send me last chance. Thank you.
Thank you, Ashnadal, for that. Thank you, everyone, for joining today and making everyone's effort a great success. I think this may be the first time we have had an event like this, but it should not be the last. We must have events like this again and again every year. Thank you very much from the bottom of my heart for giving this little mad idea of mine fruit and making it a success. Thank you, President Trish. Thank you, EC members. Thank you, board directors and editors, past, present, future, and all past international presidents. And all members here. Thank you. See you at the convention at Manchester.